Hello, B here, and welcome back to Integrated Physics and Chemistry. This iced tea is delicious, and to make it a little sweeter, I added just a tiny bit of sugar to it. Unfortunately, the sugar didn't dissolve in the tea like it does when I make hot tea. I wonder why. Well, in this lesson, we will learn all about solutions, like iced tea and sugar, and the factors that affect them. But before we get started, let's look at our goals for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to define the parts of a solution, discuss the factors that affect a solute's solubility. We first define solutions in our unit covering the properties of matter. A solution is when one substance is dissolved in another substance. Usually we use the term solution to refer to a solid dissolved in a liquid, such as the sugar in my iced tea. When discussing solutions, it is sometimes easier to use key vocabulary words to describe the different parts. A solute is the solid being dissolved, such as sugar, and a solvent is the liquid that the solid is dissolved in, such as my tea. While we often assume a solution is a solid dissolved in water, that is not always the case. You can have a gas dissolved in a liquid, or even a gas dissolved in another gas. When referring to the type of solution in which a solid is dissolved in water, you can use the term aqueous solution. The prefix aqua means water, like aquatics and aqueducts. Have you ever heard of electrolyte drinks? Often, athletes need to replenish their electrolytes due to losing salt from their body through sweating. Electrolyte solutions are a specific type of solution that involve dissolving ionic compounds, like table salt, in water. These solutions are able to conduct electricity, which is where the name electrolyte comes from. This ability to conduct electricity is caused by the charged ions separating from each other. The term electrolyte solution does not apply to solutions made by dissolved molecules like sugar in water. This is because when molecules dissolve, the individual atoms don't separate. Just the individual molecules do. So, going back to my iced tea, right now all of my sugar has dissolved, but what would happen if I kept adding sugar? Eventually, no more sugar can dissolve and it starts to settle on the bottom of the glass. This is because every solution has a maximum amount of solute that can dissolve in a given amount of solvent. This is called solubility. In my iced tea example, there are three different situations when dissolving the sugar. Kind of like Goldilocks and her porridge. There is too little solute, too much solute, and the just right amount of solute. When a solution has too little solute, meaning more can be dissolved, it is called an unsaturated solution. When there is too much solute that the solute settles to the bottom, like when I added too much sugar to my iced tea, it is called a supersaturated solution. And when the perfect amount of solute is dissolved in the solvent, it is called a saturated solution. What would happen if I added the same amount of sugar to a glass of hot tea as I do to the same amount of iced tea? Usually, the hot tea will be able to dissolve more sugar. Remember when I added too much sugar to my iced tea? What would happen if I stirred that solution? If I stir it, I can get more sugar to dissolve, but I have to keep stirring because if I stop, some of the sugar may settle to the bottom. What do you think would happen if I used a sugar cube instead of regular granulated sugar? The granulated sugar would dissolve faster than the sugar cube because it has more surface area. Surface area is the amount of surface that is exposed, which is higher when you have a lot of smaller particles compared to one large particle. Increased temperature, agitation, such as stirring, and increased surface area can increase the solubility of a solute in a given amount of solvent. As we went through the lesson today, we defined a solution and identified the key components of a solution and discussed factors that affect a solute's solubility and defined different types of solutions. In our next lesson, we will discuss concentration, or how to calculate the amount of solute that is dissolved in a given amount of solvent. Until next time, remember, the universe is vast and full of surprises, so never stop exploring. I'll see you next time. Hey.